Hi everyone, welcome back to How We Homeschool. So this is a look at my K through 12 curriculum shelves, and we are a 16-year homeschooling family. I like to use more of the relaxed, eclectic Charlotte Mason method for homeschooling for about the past 10, 11 years. And what I've done is invest in curriculum that I can reuse with each child and different styles of curriculum because each child has a different style of learning. So with these next few videos, I'm going to show you my kindergarten, which I already have up, first grade and second grade, which we already have. And I'm going to show you from third grade on how I can shop my own shelves for curriculum each year and not have to spend additional hundreds of dollars on curriculum for each additional child, no matter what grade they are. So I'll show you the K through 12. And I hope you enjoy these next series of videos from Shop Your Shelves. So this is going to be a look at the third grade curriculum that's already on my shelves. I try not to spend a whole bunch of money on curriculum. I would prefer to spend the money on art supplies, experiences, field trips, possibly co-ops if we're doing a co-op that year, music lessons. I prefer to spend hundreds of dollars, if we're going to spend that much, on those types of items rather than curriculum. So here we go. We'll start out with math, and we'll be doing Life of Fred. And for third grade, we'll be going through Edgewood, Farming, Goldfish, and Honey. Honey will also probably go into fourth grade from my years of experience with Life of Fred. They usually will need to repeat Honey at least one more time once they get to that multiplication stage. To go with that, my second grade, third, and fourth grade, and maybe fifth grade, depending on the child's abilities, is I keep this book around just as extra for, not for the child to do, because I don't like doing a lot of busy work, but for them to have an extra problem or two that I don't have to come up with in my own head of a multiplication problem or a long division problem or a subtraction problem, something like that. See, it comes with plenty of practice problems. We don't even come close to doing hardly half of this, but it's just like if I know they're struggling with, like, I've got an X right here on number 3. If I know they're struggling with this concept here, then I'll go in through and say, do the first 6 problems on this row right here. And that's just how I use this book, just to keep it on hand for those early elementary years. For our English language arts, a long time ago, I found this book, which is a public school book from the 1940s. And what I've noticed with using older books from the 1940s is they tend to appear to have a lot of the same Charlotte Mason methods of schooling that we try to seek in today's curriculum. They already actually existed in several of the 1940s school books that I have. So this is an English book, language arts book for third grade, and we will work through that. And then what we also do is we do a lot of copy work, and I will also do spelling from copy work. Not from copy work, but spelling from their own writing. So whenever they're putting together a story or something, and I've noticed they've done misspelled a word, then I will take note of that, and that will become a word that they need to spell a few times to me, understand the rules of the spelling, and also possibly write a few sentences with that word in it, is what I usually like to do. But I do have the spelling power that I keep on hand for grades basically I use it from first to about eighth or possibly ninth grade, depending on the child. But usually once they're past eighth grade, you should really have those spelling skills down. It shouldn't be that difficult. Maybe they've misspelled a word here or there, but it shouldn't really be doing spelling past eighth or ninth grade. So I have this on hand if we decide that we're going to use that. And I will use this yearly. So this stays in the curriculum. And then we copy work their own writings they'll do. And we'll work from this book as well for language arts. So for history, because we are a relaxed, kind of a Charlotte Mason homeschooling family, been doing that for the past 10, 11 years, homeschooling for the past going on 16 years. For the younger grades in history, I really like to focus on Bible history. I don't focus too much on the American or the world histories, unless it's strictly from a Bible perspective. And we like to do a lot of reading. So we'll be doing Pages of History Volume 1 and Volume 2. I'll be reading that out loud. It is basically world history through the story of these two young boys that travel through time. And we'll read this daily. Now for science, because I like to do a lot of nature study in the early elementary years, they have plenty of time to learn all of your STEM projects and experiments later in life. Now, if they show an interest and they want to do those things, by all means, but we don't force labs and things like this so early in the science career. So we focus on nature, and we'll be reading through the Christian Liberty Book 3 Nature Reader and answering the questions that come at the end of each animal. And we'll also be working through the Zoology 1 Flying Creatures of the Fifth Day. These are some artwork from my first son. oh. And then he was really into Sonic. Let's see. Now there are a lot of lessons in this book, not lessons, I'm sorry, experiments at the end of each chapter. And if we read through an experiment and we think we really want to do that, then for sure we will do that. But what we'll do is read through this book, and I don't buy the journals that come along. I prefer my children to make up their own journal. Number one, you can save money like that. But number two, I find that with my other children providing the journal, it was more like a question and answer type of thing. They just did what was in the journal. And with my middle child, when I didn't provide the journals, she became much more creative at notebooking and writing things and using the book in and of itself for copy work. So we're going to go with no journals already by the publisher. I'm going to have my children make up their own journals as we go along. So that was for science. Okay, and for Bible, he will have this action Bible that he will just go through and read each night before bed. And then also what we do is I have this book, which I'll just read and we talk about, and it just is about different people of the Bible, one page of each person. So we just read that aloud. And then this is the book that I use. It's designed to use from kindergarten to 12th grade. I'll be picking it up right about the third grade. I like for them to be pretty good readers by the time I pick this up, because they'll be working just strictly from this book and the Bible, an actual Bible, not a children's Bible. So this is just a character book for men, and it talks about all these character qualities: leadership, knowledge, virtue, self-control, patience, godliness, brotherly kindness, and charity. So that is a look of our third grade curriculum from Shop Your Shelves. If you invest in the proper curriculum when you start buying curriculum for your first homeschool child, you will spend much less on years to come with subsequent children. I know that some people might say to throw your, or not throw it away, but bless others with curriculum you're possibly not using. And I do believe that is something to do. I do that always. Right now, I have some curriculum at other homeschoolers' families. Just make a note as to who you loan that out to. Then those homeschool moms can use the curriculum for free. And you get it back if you know that it's a curriculum that you're possibly going to use with subsequent children. So that will be a look at the third grade. Stay tuned for fourth grade. Bye for now.